First of all, I want to introduce y'all to Big Ron Ron from Westside Rolling Neighborhood 60s. Not only is that my homie, also we have realized that we are family members, and he's also a very close relative of the late, great Raymond Washington. So these are the reasons why I'm very excited to have him as a guest today. To give y'all a little background, y'all know where I'm from. I'm from the East Side, 97th Street. And before I was actually claiming and banging 97 East Coast, as a child, I grew up in my father's house on 99th Street, and we used to claim 99 East Side Hustlers, all of my neighbors, before we turned East Coast, which 99 East Side Hustlers is no longer. And one of my godbrothers, Maurice Williams, who also was from 99 East Side Hustlers, when we turned East Coast, because like his mama stayed on the West Side, he turned 60s. But the reason why Maurice became my godbrother is because my father purchased a house in 71, 72 on 99th Street. His across the street neighbor was a man named Michael Williams. My father's name is Tommy Williams. My oldest brother is Tommy Williams. Michael Williams had a son named Michael Williams. My brother, my oldest brother, and Tommy and Big Michael, they was best friends. Maurice was Michael's brother. We all had the same last name, Williams. So from his child, my brother, my father and his father was tight. It was a group of boys in both houses. Shout out to Michelle, their sister. But we was just always called ourselves brothers because it's Williams, we was best friends, and we grew up banging together. So when my godbrother, Maurice Williams, turned Baby Ron Ron from 6-0, without putting nothing out there, we know all the legendary shit got caught up in. Your name, cuz, to me, just been a big-ass shit before I ever got a chance to meet you from a young nigga, cuz my brother is your little homie, and I know all the business, so I'm just knowing the business. And then my homie King Ron Ron just was associated with that name. I know what it is. Damn. Years later, cuz, I'm doing this public podcasting. I'm doing interviews. I try to steer away from the raw gang content, but our history and our experience often bleeds into what I do. So just want the audience to know, April 22nd, 2023, I go to my non-affiliate cousin's birthday party. He turned 50 years old. It happened to be the same day as the Javonte Davis last fight. And I'm going there to support him. I love him to death. Shout out to Clarence. Love you, cuzzo. And as I'm there, I realize that one of his other guests is Big Ron Ron from 6-0, who is his first cousin on his father's side. That's my first cousin on my mother's side. Now, although I never got an opportunity to meet Ronnie through my young life, the other cousins on their side are like Reggie, Lester, April, Crawford, Jermaine, shout out Baby Cowboy from 9-0, my low. Them is, we grew up as cousins. I've been knowing the legend of who you are all my life through my godbrother, then through my cousins. Then Reggie, shout out Reggie, who was almost a Hoover, who grew up as one time, that was my big cousin with the most street experience that I used to lean to. He was real aggressive. I thought he was for the beef from Hoover at one point where he was claiming it. But anyway, love you, cuzzo. He used to explain to me our close connection with Raymond Washington bloodline, and I never really wanted to really believe it or buy into it or associate myself with it because I didn't really, you know how to explain it to the next nigga. But the fact that in 2023 I bump into you at my family member shit, and you love him like I love him, and we, and plus the Maurice, I'm just very honored to have you here today, big homie, on my mama.
All the time.
So the title of this podcast is Facts Over Feelings. I know you just did a very long stretch. Before we get into the lot of random conversation that I would like to have, I just want to give you opportunity to, you know, explain to the audience a little bit of your history, you know, whatever you would like to do as far as introduction of yourself, a little bit what you've been through and what you're looking to do on the positive side now that you're back out here amongst the wild.
Okay, well, yeah, my name is Ron. You know, they call me Ron Ron. As he mentioned, Reggie is my first cousin. April is my first cousin. You know, their daddy and my daddy are brothers. Raymond Washington is our uncle, which is my father's brother.
That's deep.
You know what I'm saying? My father's the oldest of five.
Okay.
So it's my dad, which is Ronnie Joe, is Donald Ray, is Reggie, is Raymond, and is Derod.
Okay.
So it's five boys by my grandmother. So that's my grandmother hard. Be 93 next month.
She's still alive.
She's still kicking.
God bless Granny.
Around.
Oh, my mama. Love you, Granny.
Yeah. So
growing up, being a youngster, knowing that you was that close to the originator of all this, how did that influence you? And just how was that? And still knowing that to this day, like.
I never told nobody who my uncle was. I never told nobody that. Nobody wouldn't have never known unless the All Hood magazine came out and Kev Mack interviewed my pops.
Okay.
You understand? They interviewed Derod. They interviewed, you know, and they wouldn't have never known because I never broadcast that. I never put that out there.
You being a youngster jumping off the porch and being involved in activities, was it directly under his influence or separate?
I think it was kind of separate because I grew up around who I grew up around, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of the things that happened before I was even gangbanging, as far as I could tell a cat can ask me where I'm from, and I could say, I don't bang, but where you live? I said, I live over here. He said, oh, you from Spoopty Whoop, and they'll try to rush you, and all that old type of stuff. And you'll be like, damn, man, I might as well just, motherfucker gonna just be jumping on the cat because of where he live, he might as well be from over here.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I'm getting beat up for this shit or getting jumped for this shit, so let me just go ahead and, you know, do what I do. And that's what happened, really. I grew up around the homies and stuff. And
when they break it down from the fronts to the hills, like, what you affiliate with?
I'm out the back. The Overhills. But, you know, before it was Overhill, it was Backhood. You know what I mean? So, yeah. I'm a Backhood baby. But I'm a hill baby, if you really want to
say that.
Hill baby.
It's all six of them.
It's all one.
Right.
I don't push one without pushing the other. You know,
like
what I'm
on
saying?
My side, I push all up too. I get it.
So today in my life today, I just feel like if a cat asks me who I am, I tell him I'm around, but formerly.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, if you want to know where I'm from, I was from 60s. Mm-hmm. All that.
Yeah, I'm section, from. It's different. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm from 60s, but if you know where I want to, where I grew up, I grew up in Overhills, Backhood.
Right.
But at the end of the day, I kicked it from all through the hood. I didn't section myself. So I was everywhere in the hood. Can't nobody say that I just stayed back here. I was everywhere in the hood.